It is that time of the year again.
Oh, no, it isn't.
Oh, yes, it is.
Oh, okay.
Yes, it is indeed. It is Panto time. And this year's Tivoli Panto is Cinderella, starring a brilliant cast, including Mrs. Brown's voice, much-loved Rory Cowan.
Thanks very much for having me here.
Oh,
I'm really looking forward to it.
I'm so delighted to have you here.
I'm thrilled.
Mrs. Brown's voice is such a massive, massive success.
Thank God.
Thank God. Did you guys ever envision that it would just go global and everyone would go crazy for it?
We always knew something. When we were touring, we always knew something was going to happen because we were pulling in big audiences. Like, we could sell out the Olympia for 3 weeks, or we could sell out the Pavilion in Glasgow, and all the way down to Birmingham, we were selling out big venues for 3 weeks at a time, 1,500, 2,000 seaters.
Wow.
South of Birmingham now, you couldn't give us away free with a packet of Daz. But then when Mrs. Brown's Boys went on television, it went from doing 2,000 seaters to 10,000 seater
wow.
arenas. And we did six nights in the O2 in London last year, and they told us we could have done 30.
Wow.
So you're into Michael Jackson type territory there.
Yeah.
So we always knew something was going to happen and something was going to come along that would make it even bigger, but nobody could have thought that we'd be going in doing six nights in arenas all over the UK, playing to 60,000 people a week, and then going to Australia this year, and we played to 400,000 people out there. It's the top show on Australian television.
Absolute madness.
Top show in Canada. It's going to be
And they've done
in
like
America,
remakes in other countries and stuff.
Oh, yeah, it's called Tanti Florica in Romania.
Whoa. Well, look, let's have a quick look at a clip right now.
Oh, yeah.
I feel stupid. You should have read the invitation properly. It said dress fancy.
I thought it said fancy dress.
Easy mistake to make. That is absolutely brilliant. Do you know what? Watching that show, we can't stop giggling, but I hear that when you're on set, it's the same for you guys as well.
It's unbelievable because we rehearse the shows. Now, we never rehearse a live show. We could be opening in front of 10,000 people and your lines, because Brendan doesn't like rehearsing. So you go on the stage and Mrs. Brown directs when you're on the stage. She'll say, oh, how are you, Rory? Sit down there, or upstairs, or go over there. So you know where you have to stand. All you have to do is know your lines. But when we're doing the TV show, we rehearse it to within an inch of its life.
Uh-huh.
But Brendan, we record it in front of a live audience. So what happens with Brendan is he listens. He harks back to his stand-up days. If the audience isn't responding as he had hoped they would, he'll change things immediately. And of course, he doesn't tell us he's going to do it. Like, there's things like he hid phones in me pockets and stuff like that, and the phone would ring, and I was convinced it wasn't my phone. And if it works and if it's funny, they leave it in, even though it's a genuine mistake on my part. And of course, I'm a Mrs. Brown's fan anyway, and I have the best seat in the house whether we're on television or whether we're on the stage. I'm right beside her. And she has Mrs. Brown has amazing, hysterical, hilarious expressions on her face.
Mm-hmm.
She's about 12 of them, and she uses them all bang, 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 bang at me. And of course, I start laughing, and I'm going, oh, for God's sake, I'm in my head. I'm saying, Rory, you're in the show, you're not at the show, cut it out. And I can't, it's like if you're in a church and you get the giggles, it makes you worse.
Rory, we're going to run out of time. We haven't even talked about the panto yet.
Oh,
tell
yes.
Tell us about your part in it.
The panto, I'm playing an ugly sister called Barbie.
Barbie.
I'm one of the two ugly sisters. The other one is Buffy.
There we are.
Oh, yeah. Look at me. Don't I look fabulous?
No,
I don't. I won't look like that on the stage because that was done for the... There's
the
other sister, Buffy there beside me, Rob Murphy. Alan Hughes is in it, and it's written by Carl Broderick. And then we also have Niamh Kavanagh, who won the Eurovision back in 1993. And it's Cinderella. It's on in the Tivoli. All the details will be on panto.ie.
Brilliant. Panto.ie.
Yeah,
and what day does it start?
It opens on the 10th, next Wednesday.
Excellent.
And
all
it
right.
is really hilarious. I mean, I'm going to be like Mrs. Brown with me. I'm going to start laughing.
Well,
I know
we
I will.
Are going to be there in the front row laughing along.
I know, do. And I tell you, it's worth the ticket price if you go to see me singing and dancing.
Come
because
here.
I can't do
we
either.
We couldn't have you here without asking you to take part in a little mini Elevate Panto. Would you be up for that?
Okay,
Come on, let's go for it. There's a script there for you, Breach. You've got a script.
I'm
ahead in position. The scene is set.
Here.
We're in the kingdom of Dusseldorf in a dark forest. You are Princey Winsomus. You are Diana. Take it away.
Go on, Rory.
Oh, heavens, Benici. What am I going to do? Peter the Pink Panther has been chasing me around this haunted forest all day, and I can't hack it anymore. It's wrecking me noggin.
Fear not, Princey Winsomus. The feared creature has been banished from the land.
Oh, no, I haven't.
Who said that?
Look out, he's
Oh, no, he's not.
Oh, yes, he is.
Oh, no, he's not.
No, but he is.
Oh, yes, I am.
No, Peter, please, have mercy on me, you fell beast. I beg forgiveness for me deeds.
The only way you will ever be forgiven is if Benici fulfills what was written in the prophecy.
What did the prophecy say?
The prophecy?
The prophecy, ooh. Yes, indeed. Benici must interview a megastar.
Ah, here, let it go. Okay, no, fine, yeah, let's do it. Let's do this thing.